Hi, my name's Adam Chamberlain and welcome to this week's Tip of the Week with today's golfer in association with Lynx Golf. Here's my top five tips to help maintain your golf swing. Number one is impact. Impact is the most important part of the golf swing, and we're going to start there. Now, first thing we need to understand is what impact looks like. Now, here's my setup position, and it's very different from my setup. The weight moves forwards, the handle's more in front, my club and left arm is in a line here, and this is what impact looks like. And all the greatest players in the history of the game look very, very similar in this position, so we need to work on it. Now, the downside is we can work on it nicely in front of a mirror in a static position, but this happens in a fraction of a second during our swing, so we need to work on it dynamically. So what we're going to do is we're going to make some small swings, roughly waist high, come down, rehearse impact, but then we're going to make sure we're rotating through to waist high on the other side. And we're going to just start off small and slowly, trying to get in that good impact position and train it. Now, all you then do is build it up into a bigger swing. And this is going to help us control the club face through the golf ball like this, so that we can have the club face squarer for longer. Basically, what happens is if you don't do this, we end up leaning back, club face turns over, there's far too much rotation of the club face causing inconsistency. So work on this impact drill to help improve your golf swing. Number two is balance. Balance is one of the most important things within your golf swing, and we're going to show you how to work on it. So the first thing is in setup. Get into your setup position. We want to make sure we don't have too much weight on our toes, too much weight on our heels, and we want to feel very connected to the ground. So we even feel like we're sitting into the ground. This is going to help us swing the club really quickly, but in balance, and that helps you become more consistent. So what drills can we use to help work on this? Feet together drill, great drill. Swing backwards and through quickly, but trying to maintain really good balance. Because we're in an off-balance position, you're going to feel like you're wobbling. So it's a great drill to help work on it. Another one that's slightly harder from this is feet together, tiptoes of the back foot. This again is really, really good. Swing the club quickly, try and maintain your balance. And again, another one is moving your weight backwards and forwards. But again, keep the speed up to help work on your balance. So it looks like this. Balance is one of the most crucial parts of your game. Work on it, and I promise it'll help you play better. Now, number three is strike. Now, how can we work on strike, and also what is it? So strike is where your club is contacting the ground. It's really, really important to understand this. So we're trying to contact the ball either fractionally before it, under it, or just after the ball. Now, most people talk about hitting the ground just after the ball. Not a bad image for most golfers. And why is that? Now, I'm going to use a stick and place this kind of somewhere 4 inches behind the ball, roughly speaking. Can go further back or closer depending on what you're working on. But most people that we see are trying to help the ball in the air, they're leaning back, and they'll end up hitting the ground way before the golf ball. So this stick is gonna make a noise, it's gonna kind of ting on you when you hit it. So what we're trying to do is make our normal setup position like this, and we're gonna try and hit the ball and make sure that we don't hit this stick. And it should look something like this. Now, another quick tip for when you're on the golf course with a strike is this. Here's the golf ball. Make sure you have a practice swing. Use the back of the ball as a rough guide and notice, oh, hang on, that's too far back. So now I'd have another practice swing and make sure I contact the ground in the right place for my golf swing. Train your strike, and this again is going to improve your golf swing. Number four is ball control. Now we need to work hard on controlling the ball. So here's a good drill. I've got an alignment stick sitting out there. Make sure it's placed away from you. We've got some foam padding on it, and we're going to try and work on starting some to the right and drawing it back, starting some to the left and fading it back, so we can figure out which shots work best for us. Start with a draw. So I'm going to aim a little bit to the right. I'm going to try and start it right and draw it back. That was pretty good. And now I'm going to go straight in and try and fade it back. Good. two good shots there. But most of you are going to find a pattern of shots that works best for you. You're either going to be more of a fader or more of a drawer. Work on tightening that pattern so you can control the start direction and the curve. This is going to help you play better. Number five is rhythm and timing. And for me, it's the real glue that fixes a good swing together. And it's something that most people overlook. So how can we work on it? So one of the things I want you to think about here is having a trigger to move away from the ball. You need to make sure you have something, either a little forward press or something like Matt Wolf does, kind of like this way, maybe not quite as quick as he does that. Some people put the knee forward, hands forward, something that kind of helps everything start in some motion. It's really, really important. So try one of those and figure out which one works for you. But also I want you to do is make some slow motion swings, hitting some balls and gradually building up the speed until you can kind of get to full power. So it almost looks like you did when you started. It's really, really important to make sure your club, your arms and your body are working together in really good rhythm and timing. Another really good drill is to go to the top of the swing. And this is especially good for those players that get quick from the top. So I want you to go to the top of the swing, stop, count to two, one, two, hit it, and you'll be amazed with how much better your rhythm and timing is, and it will help you play better. So just to recap, the five key ingredients to help maintain your game: impact, balance, strike location, ball control, and finally rhythm and timing. These will help you play better golf.